Okay, in this video, let's talk about how exactly should we answer the integral of 1 over 1 minus x squared dx. I will give you guys 3 possible answers for this. 2 of them, they are really similar, but they are also really confusing. In fact, let's talk about those 2 first. And in fact, they are also the easier one. Anyway, for these 2, we will have to rely on the fact that the derivative of these 2 functions will give us 1 over 1 minus x squared. And the first function is the inverse hyperbolic tangent. So if you differentiate this, if the input is just x, you do get 1 over 1 minus x squared. Well, if you differentiate the inverse hyperbolic cotangent of x, in fact, you also will end up 1 over 1 minus x squared. I have a video on this, so be sure you guys go check that out if you haven't seen it already. And you guys can also check it on my shirt. Yes, if you differentiate this and that, you do get this and that for the derivative. So, is there any difference though? Yes. They are not exactly the same function, okay? When you do this, you have to be really careful. This right here, you have to focus on the domain of the inverse hyperbolic tangent. The domain for this is anything between of negative 1 and 1, not including the endpoints. So this only works, I will just write this down right here for you guys, if the absolute value of x is less than 1. Okay? So that's the domain for this. So in order for you to make sense of this expression, you have to make sure the absolute value of x is less than 1, because that's the domain for the original function here. And you might guess it. For this right here, for the inverse hyperbolic cotangent, the domain for that is the greater than 1 version. So, for example, if you have to plug in, let's say, 5 for x, you will have to look at this right here to make sense. And 5 for x right here, it doesn't even make sense at all, right? Unless we're talking about complex numbers, but no, we're not. Well, so what good does this do? So, of course, if you integrate this, you'll get that. If you integrate that, you should get that. And it depends. Sometimes if you have a limit of integrations or not. And of course, if x is equal to 1, you will get an improper integral, so you have to do more investigation. But I will tell you guys this right here. I will just write down, if you want to integrate 1 over 1 minus x squared dx, this right here is equal to the inverse hyperbolic tangent of x plus c, and you just have to make sure that if the absolute value of x is less than 1, especially if you are integrating maybe from 0 to 1 half, then use this right here. If you're integrating from negative a quarter to positive 0.85, use this right here, right? But if you are integrating 1 over 1 minus x squared dx, maybe from 2 to 5, well, you will have to use this right here because of the domain. So this right here is the inverse hyperbolic cotangent of x plus c, and this right here is if the interval of integration is, you know, you're talking about greater than 1. And you might be thinking, what if the integral is from 0 to 5? In that case, you have to break down into 2 integrals, from 0 to 1, and then from 1 to 5. And both of them are improper, so you have to do more investigation on, you know, both ends. But, you know, this is pretty much the main dish, right? So, these are the 2 answers, and this C and that C, of course, are different for, you know, just put on constant integration. And this is not so good. Here is actually the better one. So, this is the first answer, the second answer. The third answer is that you actually have to do partial fractions for the following. And perhaps let's just do it on the side right here real quick. So here's the deal. I'll just put down a note right here. If you really want to integrate 1 over 1 minus x squared dx without using the hyperbolic trig functions, the inverse or whatever, do the following. Factor the denominator, you get 1 minus x plus 1 plus x, right? And then you could do the cover-up method. So this right here, when you factor 1 minus x times 1 plus x, if you want to figure out the constant right here, this is 1 minus x, so you come back to here, cover this up. Well, how can you make this factor equal to 0? X has to be what? X has to be 1, because 1 minus 1 is 0. So x is 1. You put 1 right here, because you cover this up already. So you put 1 right here, so you, altogether you get 1 over 1 plus 1, which is just 1 half. And then, if you look at this right here, you go back to the original, you cover this up, and you have to let x equal to what to make this factor 0? Negative 1, right? So you have to put negative 1 right here, so you have 1 over 1 minus negative 1, which is 1 over 2 again, so like this. And now, both of them have the 1 half, so I can factor that all the way in the front. And then, when you integrate 1 over 1 minus x, this right here is not just ln, and technically you have to put down the absolute value of 1 minus x, but the derivative of 1 minus x is negative 1. And when you do the integration, you divide it by that derivative, which is you divide it by negative 1, which you have to include a negative right here, and just put it like this. Yeah. And then I put the 1 half all the way in front already, so I'll just put down 1 over 1 plus x. When you integrate that, you get positive ln absolute value of 1 plus x. And of course, the derivative of 1 plus x is just 1, so this right here just like that. And then you see this is 1 half. And inside, we'll just combine the natural logs. This has a negative, so this will be in the denominator. This right here will be on the numerator. So we have the absolute value of 1 plus x over this right here, 1 minus x, like that. And in the end, we're done, plus c. And the idea is that thanks to the absolute value, x can be anything except for 1 or negative 1, because as if x like that. And here, thanks to the absolute value, x can be anything except for 1 or negative 1, because if x is equal to 1, you see the 0 in the denominator. If x is equal to negative 1, you see ln of 0. Both of them are not defined. We can also see from here, right? So I'll come here and write down this for you guys. This is 1 half ln absolute value 1 plus x over 1 minus x. And then we are done, so you can put a plus c right here. And once again, this is for the situation if x is not equal to plus minus 1. And of course, this is pretty much the domain for this function, right? And in fact, this and that, they all have a really nice connection. If you guys watch my other video, I showed you guys how to write this and that in terms of ln. So be sure you guys go watch that. And once again, if you have to integrate from 0 to 5, for example, in fact, the third one right here, it's the best, because you still have to break down into two integrals, from 0 to 1 and from 1 to 5. Both integrals can be done with this and plugging values. But if you have to integrate from 0 to 5, well, from 0 to 1, you will have to use this for the answer, and then from 1 to 5, you will have to use that for the answer, and then, once again, both of them are improper integrals, so you will have to do it carefully. Anyway, this is right here is it, and maybe you guys can also work on another formula. What if you have a squared minus x squared in the denominator instead of just a 1 minus x squared, right? Perhaps I'll do that for you guys another time. So hopefully this clears things up a little bit. And let me know if you guys have any questions down below. And as always, that's it.